Welcome to another episode of Basketball Babas. I am Basketball John.
Baba.
That's John. A good name, Basketball John.
I am Baba John.
And I am Baba Ashwin.
I'm Banarsi Baba K.
And welcome to the
Welcome to all our babies.
We welcomed them in the previous episode.
Oh, are they still here?
Yeah, they're still here only. If you both are wearing the same robe, they are still here.
They're still here. And my bad. That's my
It's
bad.
Okay. Welcome to all our babies. This is part two of the 2019 NBA playoffs predictions. We are talking about the West this episode. We discussed the East. We finished the East on some ridiculous note. I urge you to check it out and wait. In social media talk, wait for it. Like genuinely speaking, wait for it. Like Baba K doesn't disappoint in that episode. Let's quickly get started on the West.
Yes, sir.
The one seed and the eighth seed. Mm-hmm. The Warriors versus the unexpected, great, in my opinion, one of the best stories of the NBA this season, the LA Clippers. Yeah. Thoughts, Ashwin?
Yes, they are one of the most underrated teams. I think it's easy. Clippers are going to sweep the Warriors.
Just like I said, Baba John. Okay.
They've done very well to get to this team, to this part of the season. I think they beat out Sacramento, right? I mean, it's a little sad that they ended up at the 8th seed because they had to face the Warriors. But yeah, I mean, let's not kid anyone. This is...
I like that video of... I think it came out today or it came out yesterday. Doc Rivers walking. ESPN said 33 wins. Oh, yeah. Charles Barkley said 33 wins. And now we are in the playoffs. And like he pops open the champagne. Right. I think Gallon pops open the champagne.
They played amazingly well. I absolutely love Patrick Beverley, even though he's a little bitch, but whatever. Gallinari, like it's a very good team, but you know, it's really sad that they had to face the Warriors in the first round. It's just sad. I mean, because this is like the Pacers, this is one of the best stories of the NBA this season.
I personally don't think anything is sad. I think it's just great that they're here. I think they're enjoying it. I think that's what's great, right? You want to enjoy them. I think they're going to play this series again because everybody knows that they're betting against them. My worry is, and this is a genuine problem, I really like Patrick Beverley for the grit that he brings to the game, but I'm genuinely worried for Curry's health and Thompson's health.
Anyone going against Patrick
Beverley. Yeah, like it's ridiculous, man. I mean, this man, okay, everybody talks about how hard nose, but he's just an asshole.
Hard nose, hard elbows, hard knees.
Dude, I get you have to win at any cost and stuff like that, but he just plays dirty and it's just really crappy. Offensively, defensively, the Warriors just blow them out of the park. It's not even a competition. I think prediction scoreline.
I'll say 4-1. Even though that is I'm sure I'm going to be wrong, but I'll say 4-1.
I'm inclined to agree with you. I think the Clippers kind of managed to steal either Game 3 or Game 4. Game 3 or Game 4.
Maybe Game 4 they all rest. They're like,
I think, and also I also have a feeling that the Warriors will take this a little lightly. As a matter of fact, you know, like they've been the entire season. Baba K.
Yes, sir.
Do we agree that... Okay.
I first of all agree that yes, it is. To me also, it seemed like a 4-1 kind of series.
Right.
Because the Warriors are taking it easy, not taking them seriously. And I think I also agree with you when you said it's kind of a happy thing that the Clippers are here playing the Warriors because they have all the spotlight on them too. They will be one of the most watched teams in the playoffs. So it's like these role players will have their moment in the shine. Yeah. Even if they lose, they'll show what they're worth.
Right.
So that said, like, you know, to continue like what we had finished the last episode with, like, because we're talking about like how each team can perhaps win the NBA championship.
Right.
You know? For the Warriors, it's easy. Everyone's healthy.
Yeah.
Like everyone's healthy, they win it. Like for the Clippers. So I was thinking about this.
Yeah.
This could be. And 2007, Warriors were the 8th seed. Mavericks were the 1 seed.
Whoa.
This could be that version of We Believe, where everything just clicks, where it doesn't make any reasonable sense because the Mavericks were better than those Warriors almost on every edge of the way. But all of a sudden, Lou Williams will be like the new Baron Davis, is destroying everybody. You know,
Beverly's going to destroy two ankles.
Draymond punches KD. Yeah, like it just brings them to the next level. So that is the first round. Now, Beverly, this is where his heroicness comes in. On his way to a championship, Beverly breaks Curry's ankles, Westbrook's ankles, Harden's ankles, and Giannis's ankles.
No crossover involved. It just breaks in.
So yeah, he's like, just give me your ankle.
Yeah, 4-4-4-4. And Landry Shannon is the next Ray Allen. So when all of these things align, the Clippers will win the title.
I was just going to throw something at you if you would say Shamit rhymes with Allen or some shit like that. But I genuinely think that, see, the thing is the Clippers, you know, normally you say you have these, sorry, it's okay.
Wow.
Director, please.
Babaji.
You know, they say irrational confidence, guys. Yes. I think it's an irrational confidence team.
Yes.
So which is why I think they steal one game. The odds of them coming out of this series are very limited unless, like you said, like Baba K decides, you know, Beverly breaks ankles, Lou Williams like becomes the next. He becomes a reincarnation of some, I don't know, great. And, you know, Shamit becomes a real. What a ridiculous prediction, man.
For them to win the title, he has to.
He has to.
So I think we agree on this. I don't see any conversation happening. Do you see any interesting matchups though here? I'm looking forward to the Thompson versus Lou Williams matchup.
Yeah, Curry or Thompson. Like, cause I think Shea Gilgeous Alexander might. I think he's like a taller guard.
Right.
So the matchups might be that he might be against Clay. Or
he's a rookie, right?
Yeah. Clay will probably defend Lou because he's the better defender. And
exactly.
Then, yeah.
Cool. So 4-1.
Yeah.
4-1?
Yes.
Okay. So again, we agree. 4-1. Okay. Next series, which I think is going to be another. I'm predicting to be a 7-game series.
I'm not going to say what my prediction is.
Second seed Denver Nuggets versus the 7th seed San Antonio Spurs.
Upset. I had to say it. I could not stop it. I'm sorry. I know you're going to do a long winding there, but this is my upset of the series. I think Spurs beat the Nuggets.
Scoreline?
4-2.
4-2?
I don't think the Nuggets...
You think the Nuggets only win 2 games in this series?
Yeah. I think the Spurs just managed to
what
get...
What was wrong? Okay.
I'll tell you why. Because if
what was wrong for the Nuggets?
What was wrong for the Nuggets? Jokic can't do the things that he did in the regular season. Who else is there? They have Gary Harris and who's that other scorer?
I mean, they are crunch time. Could be Jamal Murray, Gary Harris, Will Barton, Paul Millsap, Jokic.
No, I'm saying this more from a, like, Popovich beats Mike Malone.
Yeah.
I think this is, if I had to put money on an upset, this is the only chance for an upset.
And 4-2.
4-2.
Baba K?
4-3 also.
Baba K?
You know, I'm not 100% disagreeing with him. I think the Nuggets will probably win this series, but you know what? I would not bet too much on it. I think it'll be a very close series. The Spurs will push them to a limit. I doubt that the Spurs, with the way they play, are going to be able to run the Nuggets, especially in Denver, where it's like always hard for away teams. So I think the Nuggets will win, but it's... I think we had this moment in the previous episode too. If what you say happened, it would not surprise me. Okay. I think I would not be surprised at all that if the Spurs win this, you know. Popovich is the man. So.
Yeah. I'm picking Nuggets in 7, but I have two issues here. One is you don't want to bet against Pop.
Yeah.
He's managed to make this raggedy-ass group of people. Like, who would have thought Rudy Gay, LaMarcus Aldridge, DeRozan, like White and Forbes would actually be a playoff team.
Yeah.
You know, like it's quite incredible.
They don't even have a point guard even. Like,
yeah, like Derek White's not necessarily. Yeah. Derek White actually.
No, I like Derek
too.
I like him.
But if you watch his game, he's more classically. Like Patty Mills ideally should have been their point guard, but he's coming off the bench and he needs to come off the bench. Yeah. He's the energy guy.
You know who the Spurs could have used? This guy called Tony Parker. He would have been really good for them.
Who's this Tony Parker?
But here's what's interesting, and this is why I feel there may be a bit of a challenge with the Spurs taking this. Is they are horrific on the road this season. They're 16-25 on the road, and Denver are one of the best home teams. That's where I feel like, because then Denver obviously have home court advantage. Yeah. That's where I feel they could stand. But like I said, two things. One is you just don't want to bet against the Spurs.
Yeah.
Bet against Popovich and the Spurs. This is Denver Nuggets. There's a possibility this is going to be Denver Nuggets deer in the headlights moment.
Yeah.
I think they're going to come across, because, and all these guys have had playoff experience, right? Except for White and Forbes. But the rest of the crew, whether it's Mills,
Popovich has some 1,000 years of playoff experience.
Yeah, the main three players on the Spurs are all playoff tested veterans. So I think it's just going to be an interesting matchup. I think the Denver Nuggets win this 4-3, but really, really hard to predict against the Spurs. So here's the first disagreement. Do you think Spurs win it 4-2?
4-2. 4-2. Yeah.
You and I 4-3 Nuggets. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Question. How do either the Nuggets or the Spurs win the championship?
I'll go by this quickly. The Nuggets, they are the second best passing team in the league behind the Warriors. Mm. But they don't have the Warriors turnover issues.
Right.
They take better care of the ball.
Much better care.
And like, we've seen that this happened with the magical 2014 Spurs, and this happened with these last 4 years of the Warriors, that the best passing teams can usually like really blow teams out. If things are going right for them, things can work.
Especially in the playoffs, yeah.
Jokic basically becomes Bill Walton in his prime. He's like, I'm not saying, I mean, this, it not sounds ridiculous, but I think he can get close to it, you know. He's probably the best passing big man we've seen in a long time.
Very.
And Jokic, an additional point, Jokic learns how to jump. Jokic has...
You lost me.
Jokic has my...
This is his recorded vertical.
I'm just saying, yeah. Jokic has my vertical, and he's one of the NBA's best players. So if he just gains a bit better than me, they might go really far. Now, as for the Spurs, magical pop season where the role players basically don't miss. And they've had a really good bench all season.
Right.
And then it just clicks for them that they just... The entire bench becomes like a 2014 bench. They just run through everybody, you know. LaMarcus, DeRozan and Rudy Gay basically make the three-point shot obsolete. They bring back mid-range.
Nice. I like that.
Yeah.
Finally, I agree.
The analytics masters.
Yeah.
And Tim Duncan unretires and joins them in the post.
You don't need to get that crazy also.
Yeah, man. That's okay. He's looking in good shape.
The shape wasn't that crazy. But see, that's my agree with the LaMarcus, Rudy Gay and DeRozan thing. I think it's just going to be really interesting if they decide, screw the three-pointer. We're going to be doing
it. We're going to be the anti-Rockets.
Yeah. okay, so... We are good with that. We feel that you say the Spurs in yes. 6, we both say the Nuggets in 7. Any other additional points on the way to the finals?
You're also
WI.
WI is anywhere.
Except for W. Yeah. Except for, no, even for the Warriors. Yeah. If they implode, then they don't become
champions. Yeah, they're the ones. Huh, exactly.
Okay. Okay, the next series. Director, please bring some tissue for this gentleman here.
I can't drop you.
The next series. The Portland Trailblazers versus the Oklahoma City Thunder. Thoughts? And
yeah, addiction? I mean, especially that Nurkic is out. This is what we wanted. Like, we did not want to face the Warriors. We did not want to face Nuggets. We did not want to face Rockets. This is what we wanted, and this is the best case scenario for OKC. Only thing is, we don't have home court advantage, but I feel. The main matchup here is the point guard matchup. We have them beat on everything else. We should win this series in 5 games. Yeah, 5.
In 5?
Yeah. I think 4-1 should be the final score.
I'm saying that...
I mean, we did beat them in the regular season.
Yes, and as a matter of fact, I mean, not by large numbers,
but it is still we.
I think you all won all games by a total of 2 plus 9, 11, 11 plus 9,
20.
28 points across 4 games.
I mean, it was close. It's not a blowout by any chance.
Yeah, I think this is going to be OKC. I think Thunder come through. But I think it's going to be... I think Blazers win 2 games. I think the Nurkic injury really, really screwed their season.
Yeah.
I think it's... If Nurkic is on there, I think Blazers are a championship contender, WI. I think the Nurkic injury has really, really screwed them.
Hmm. I mean, if Nurkic was not injured, definitely they would have won more games than what I said.
I think they would have beaten the Thunder. I genuinely feel that. And I find it interesting that you say the Thunder didn't want to match up with the Nuggets. I think they would have hammered the Nuggets.
No.
I feel
absolutely
so.
Absolutely not. Nuggets are a really good passing team. There's no way Thunder can match up with that.
But it's about the fact that the Thunder bring grit and playoff experience, which the Nuggets are completely... I think the two guards would have murdered the Nuggets guards. It would have been a criminal offense. Like, you would have to call in the chalk and stuff like that. Baba K?
Yes. One more thing. I think even McCollum is a little injured. That's why I made it 4-1. Like, otherwise, Blazers are good enough to win the 2 games on their thing. It's just that, like, all the offensive load has come on to Lillard. I'm pretty sure McCollum is injured.
I feel like Lillard has moved on from that one Lillard game a series to now two Lillard games a series. Mm-hmm. I think there'll be a 40-point game, and I won't be surprised if he drops. Yeah, there'll be like a 40. There'll be two 40-10 games. He'll just go bonkers. Like he'll lose his shit. Baba K, how do the Blazers and the Thunder become champions?
So first of all, I tend to agree with you here that like I think it's going to be a 6-game series, but going towards the Thunder. And I think Lillard is one of the most criminally underrated players in the NBA. In my opinion, he's better than Kyrie. Some people might disagree, but I just think that he has done more, proved to me more as an alpha dog himself, carrying what aren't very great teams actually, like in a vacuum. In the West, give them competitive every year, you know?
Yeah.
He's super clutch. So I say all that to say they're still going to lose the series. between Russ and Paul George and Steven Adams and I would have had Thunder winning even if Nurkic was healthy. I just think Thunder have, you know, they hurt themselves more than anyone else hurts them.
Right.
But they are just the better team flat out in my opinion, and they should win this series.
I'm gonna cry.
As for winning a championship potentially, I'll start with the Blazers first.
This is the best part of this podcast.
Lillard and CJ become Stephen Clay. Yeah. I mean, not that far off.
Close enough.
They are a high scoring team. They take it to the next level. They finish as the best scoring team in the playoffs. They basically outscore everyone.
Okay.
You know? They finish as the number one rebounding percentage team. And I know Nurkic is missing.
Okay.
But they have like a lot of guys who rebound well, and Warriors traditionally struggle against tough rebounders. And
go for it.
2007 Greg Oden.
Oh god.
Oh no! Y'all had this massive argument about this yesterday. I took these guys for a drink and oh my god, it became a Durant versus Oden conversation. So 2007 Oden.
Yeah, finally proves the world that he should be number one over Kevin Durant. Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
I was so expecting him to say Jack Ramsey decides to come and coach the Blazers again with 76. Thankfully, he's reached only 2007. He has potential to go back to the 76 Blazers.
As for the Thunder, PG is the best two-way player in the NBA.
Yes, hands down.
Russ, his field goal shooting was 43%, and his three-pointers was 29%. Terrible. He improves those numbers to 45 and 35.
Okay.
Like I know it sounds
very doable. But very doable.
But still, like he, if he shoots 35 from three, the game changes for them. Like all of a sudden, the floor becomes bigger for everybody else. You know, Steven Adams is actually Khal Drogo, and Game of Thrones is coming back, and he sees Khaleesi on screen, and he just takes it to the next level.
Khaleesi comes in the game. Right?
He sees it and he's motivated now, and he takes things to the next level.
Khaleesi attends the OKC home games in the getup.
As Khaleesi, like the white hair.
Yeah, absolutely, know. Absolutely.
And Adams plays as Drogo also. Like he doesn't wear a jersey. He's a loincloth. Or lungi pant.
I definitely know when I see Steven Adams playing in a loincloth.
Oh, that'll be dangerous. Yeah.
But here's my thing. The Westbrook improvements is actually not far off.
It's not that far off.
And I know you sniggered a little.
Yeah.
But 45% for most people is not great for in terms of okay playoffs. You need to get to at least 50, especially the great players. But the thing is, Westbrook does so much other stuff. Exactly. Like people. There's a massive conversation happening between whether he's actually a selfish player and actually an unselfish player because he leads the league with assists and stuff like that.
Those people.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah. See, but there is a valid argument, right?
Absolutely.
But you and I will argue about this later. put a couple of drinks in you. But even if Westbrook gets to 45 and 35 is what you said? 45 and 35?
35 from the three. I think that's a game changer.
I think for me personally as a OKC fan, but still, it's not about his percentage. It's just that he has to shoot less and facilitate more. But even still make that mid-range jumper. Because the problem is when the jumper doesn't go in, he starts attempting more of it instead of attempting less of it.
Right.
Because he's willing himself. It's like one of those Kobe mentalities coming in. Like, nikal last to nikal ke aaj to अंदर बास्केट के अंदर डाल के ही जाएंगे
व्हिच आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम इफ ही इज डूइंग इट ड्यूरिंग द गेम एज लाइक इन द फर्स्ट थ्री क्वार्टर्स माय इशू इज व्हेन ही डज इट इन द लास्ट क्वार्टर लाइक यू नो दैट्स वेयर आई थिंक ही आई एग्री विद यू
टू बी फेयर लाइक प्ले डेविल्स एडवोकेट टुवर्ड्स वेस्टब्रुक ही एक्चुअली हैज डन अ मच बेटर जॉब दिस सीजन
देन
पॉल जॉर्ज बीइंग द मैन
एब्सोल्युटली
सो I mean, obviously, we are all saying this, like,
but again,
I hope George is healthy too.
Yes.
Like, this is the major part of everything. You know? Right. So I think Westbrook has improved, and this is why I actually have a lot of belief in this team. So
Okay. Cool. The last series in the West.
Yes.
This was the last year also.
Houston Rockets versus the Utah Jazz.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say Rockets in seven.
Rockets in six.
Ashwin?
Rockets in six.
Okay.
Yeah.
Why do you think Jazz don't pull out one more game?
Because like Rockets are that much better at shooting than the like because the Rockets don't care if they miss like they could miss but it doesn't stop them.
They shot 27
three.
Made 26 or 27. Yeah. Made 27. Yeah. And then 27
is the lucky/unlucky number. Ridiculous. Okay. Huh.
I mean Utah is good but. Like even though they are really good defensively, like what is the defensive rating of
Utah is second in the league.
Second in the league. Yeah.
What's interesting is Utah is second defensively, Houston is second offensively.
Yeah.
I find that very interesting. Offensively, defensively, the other way around also is very interesting. Utah is 14th offensive. Rockets are 18th.
I can't believe they're 18th because I would have thought that they really don't care, like give two hoots about defensive. It's just that they have really hard nosed people like you know Tucker and
right.
Capella is an amazing rebounder.
Right.
All those things. It's just that they have that crazy scorer in them, like James Harden. What he's done this season, like we've already discussed that multiple times. That team is just too strong for Utah to handle. I think six games, Utah will be taken care of.
If Mitchell makes a jump from his last year's playoffs to this year's playoffs, I think the addition of somebody like Crowder who can guard the perimeter makes them a little dangerous.
Yeah.
Internally, they're already solid. I think Gobert takes charge of things there.
Yeah.
But I think last season, one of the things that they missed was a solid perimeter defender, which I think they've got in Crowder. Question is then, and it's very clear that they are going to the Jazz are going to play favors less because he's too big and the Rockets move too quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Rockets will probably play Tucker at center to kind of to compensate. Baba K, how are the Rockets and the Jazz getting to the finals or winning the championship?
Well, first of all, I have a bombshell to drop. I think Jazz are winning the series.
Whoa!
I think Jazz take this in six.
Oh my!
What? In yes. six?
This is going to be the ugliest series of the first round.
That is ridiculous.
It's going to be between the most hard-nosed defense versus free throws. Uh-huh. It's going to come down to that. It's going to be James Harden from the line and the Jazz sort of scoring sometimes and mostly not.
Hmm.
But like the same way the Utah shocked the world by beating the Thunder last year, where Ingles basically outplayed Paul George.
Yeah. Right.
I'm not saying he's going to outplay Harden.
but
I think like as a group, this is just a better organized, better working. I think the Houston Rockets, the Harden style will, if there's any antidote to that, it is a combo of someone like a Crowder on the perimeter and someone like a Gobert in the post.
Hmm.
I think that is the kind of defensive, if you need ideal defenders, I'm not saying exactly Crowder, the better defenders than Crowder, but I mean that style. Or that partnership.
And Crowder is a above average perimeter defender in the NBA.
Yeah,
so like he's a playoff defender.
I mean, that would be my ideal defensive partnership against Harden. You know,
right?
I think this will be the big upset. I really don't have faith that this. I've seen too many years where the Rockets have underperformed in the playoffs, and last year was a truly exceptional year. Chris Paul has been a shell of himself, and I see that he's going to be injured at some point in the series. Harden's going to probably get 45 a game, and I don't think it might be enough. I think this will be a shocking upset.
I have a hard time accepting the upset. I think it's going to be a 7-game series.
Yeah.
I think the Rockets win in 7. I have two issues though.
Yes.
I don't know whether CP3 lasts the entire series.
Yeah.
That's a huge question mark. And a large part of why Harden can do what Harden does. I wouldn't say large part. I said an important part of why Harden can do what Harden does is Capella.
Yes.
Right. And Gobert takes Capela out of the game.
Yes.
Like that's a, it's like Gobert takes Capela and then some.
Yeah.
Capela
yeah.
cannot match up with
Gobert. Capela, that's my, but they don't, it's not like they run plays for Capela where they give the ball and Gobert
is
giving that
card. No, my point is they're not running plays for Capela.
Exactly.
They run plays for Harden. But one of the reasons why Harden can do what he does is because Capela is so dangerous around
It's the fear of the fact that Capela might get an alley-oop.
Yeah,
But that fear will be taken away with Gobert there.
Yeah, that's my thing. I think Gobert cancels out Capela. That's my challenge. Mm. That being said, it's going to be really hard because see, Rubio is a below average defender.
Yes.
Mitchell is as good a defender as you expect a second year player to be. Like he's an NBA level.
Yeah.
So I guess what you guys are saying is defense is going to win the championship. I mean, in this series,
I am saying that defense will win.
I think the lack of defense is going to allow the Rockets to win this championship.
Rockets will win though.
Yeah, the Rockets will win. No. I think the Rockets win in seven. But my thing is that.
But if it goes in seven, then I think it's a. If it goes
the
game,
but
then
the
then
only.
I,
The only two reasons that would make me, if in case convince myself to go in the direction of Baba K, is the fact that CP3 doesn't make through the series because he's definitely going to outplay Rubio if he's healthy, and the fact that Capela takes away Gobert takes away Capela, which is a huge part of what makes Harden so great. I think it's an important factor to consider.
But now if I have to sort of predict. Either of these teams can bring
yes,
it all.
Winning it all.
Like the Rockets are the kind of team that I could even like. I might call them a force and upset, but I could also call them champions. Like
yes.
they're that wild.
Yeah, they're exactly.
Yeah. So for the Rockets, Harden basically becomes Jordan with a 3-point shot.
Right.
You know, he just averages 40 or 42 the whole playoffs.
Yeah. It's bonkers. It's very realistic.
Yeah, it's not impossible. In the Warriors matchup, they basically did what they did last year.
Right.
CP3 stays healthy.
Yeah.
And like, and then all of a sudden, and yes, they're missing Ariza, which I think is a major reason for a lot of their sort of fall this year.
Sorry, just to add your point, don't you think Kenneth Faried is probably 70% of what Ariza brought to the table?
No. They do different things. But
I'm saying, if you see what they bring to the table.
No, because Ariza's main thing was he was matched up against the best scorer on the other side.
Yeah.
Because they didn't have any other perimeter players. Faried can't do that thing. Faried is a poor man's Capela, like when Capela is on the bench, like you put Faried.
And Ariza, in my opinion, is like an exceptionally smart player.
Oh,
like he had that, like he's the Iguodala type for this team, you know, like he could fill a lot of holes. Which,
I mean, they definitely. I mean, I don't think the Rockets are gonna go anywhere past this first round.
Okay.
Because, like, you can't lose Ariza and you know still expect to perform at the same level, scoring so many points. And that's not high. That doesn't happen technically. Like, historically, that doesn't happen in the playoffs. You don't have so much.
And what about the Jazz?
Well, defense wins championships.
Finally. Started off with your rebounds with championship and you're
there
resurrecting
is,
players from the dead.
You know, Gobert, there's no answer for defense. You know, he's there. So he takes them all the way. Donovan Mitchell becomes 2006 Dwayne Wade.
Oh my God. Okay.
Ricky Rubio becomes 2008 Ricky Rubio.
Okay.
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 Joe Ingles becomes the white LeBron James.
I thought you would go with...
Are you done?
I'm done.
Thank God he didn't bring back Karl Malone and Sean Stockton. I was like totally expecting that to happen.
Nah, I was expecting that.
Yeah, because he's like James Harden will become Michael Jordan, so we'll bring back John Stockton and Karl Malone also. But I
did not expect the white LeBron James though. I was thinking
he's got all the skills of LeBron James, but none of the talents.
Man, you just made Joe Ingles' day, man. He's like, where LeBron James? Where Joe Ingles?
Hey, I saw him outplay Paul George in a playoff series.
I mean,
Joe Ingles,
sure.
Anything is
like
possible.
One of the best shooting motions.
Yeah.
So you're saying Jazz
in
six. You're saying Houston in six.
Houston
in six. I'm saying Houston in seven.
Yes.
So then let's quickly just do the predictions for the rest of the series. We all have GSW coming through, correct?
Yes.
But. You have Utah.
Yeah.
We both have Houston. JSW and Utah?
Warriors in six.
Warriors in six?
Warriors in five.
Yeah.
Warriors in five?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. I can see why that's. JSW or Houston?
I mean, if it's Warriors in Houston, then Warriors in six.
And Warriors in Utah?
Warriors in four.
They'll sweep the Jazz?
Yeah.
I don't think they sweep the Jazz. So obviously my prediction is Warriors and Houston.
I mean, we are going with everyone as healthy, okay?
Yeah, yeah, sure. I think it's going to be Warriors and Houston. And if it's through that prediction, I think it'll be the Warriors in six. But if it's the Jazz, I think it's a gentleman's sweep. I think it's the Warriors in five. I think the Jazz kind of. I think again, see, if the Warriors get Utah for some reason, it's really going to help their cause this year, because then they'll kind of also take a few nights off at the Utah. They'll kind of chill. They'll probably have one or two game rests.
What's there to rest in Utah? Utah's a Mormon city.
No, I meant to say like they'll probably keep the player on the bench. Oh. Is what I meant.
Maybe the racist trans will show up. I can't do this. I'm going away.
Oh yeah, that's another one of the X factors.
Yeah.
Racism.
Takes
the Jazz through.
Good old racism.
It's like, actually, yeah, that's a big X factor, because KD is quite thin-skinned when it comes to these
opposing teams.
Best player.
They don't want to deal with it.
And then Draymond will kick somebody in the nuts in the crowd.
Get suspended. Oh my god.
Grayson Allen is a Utah player.
Yeah. Trippy.
Famous hurter of other people. You know? Right. So he's the Pat Beverly, basically.
Yeah. So, okay. I see that. Okay. Portland, OKC. We all had OKC, I think, right?
Yes.
Yeah, we all had
OKC. Denver, San Antonio, we both had Denver. You had San Antonio.
Yeah.
If it's OKC and San Antonio, who comes through?
Either way, I think OKC is winning that series.
Okay. Yeah. And if it's OKC and Denver.
I think OKC win that in the Nuggets. Either way, it's in six, I would say.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
OKC and San Antonio?
OKC.
How, in?
It doesn't matter. Six games. Max.
Six games?
I mean, five to six.
And Nuggets?
Yeah, that's not a very good matchup for us. I would say, see, my heart wants to say OKC in four, but that is absolutely silly. I'll say Denver in seven.
Wow.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, that changes things.
But then you don't even have Denver winning so.
Yeah, but that's interesting.
I think
so,
it's a massive.
So here's here's where you and I disagree. Okay, first of all, you said San Antonio. So
here's where you and I disagree, number six.
Okay, if San Antonio come through, OKC and San Antonio, I think OKC win. So, okay, either Denver or San Antonio, I think OKC win.
Mm.
That's what I think. I think they will beat Denver in six. The OKC-San Antonio series, I have a feeling OKC have this Popovich block in their mind. And they will win the series, but I think it's going to be seven.
That doesn't matter. Okay.
I think OKC in seven, if it's the San Antonio Spurs, I think
traditionally OKC has beaten San Antonio in six games.
I was going to say, wouldn't you say Popovich has a thunder block?
Yes.
Because for the last few, I mean, in at least the KD thunder was able to.
But my point is, short answer, yes.
Yes.
But I also feel that the Thunder always, I feel like the Thunder bring their best game against Popovich. I wouldn't say they bring their best game against the Spurs.
Mm.
They bring their best game against
Popovich. They haven't faced each other in the playoffs since the KD left.
Yeah. No, but even during the seasons, if you see, it's always been very, it's just their games are very interesting. I have a feeling it's like OKC versus Popovich.
No, OKC is the antithesis of San Antonio's
course. Absolutely. Okay, so fair enough. So either ways, I feel OKC is coming through. But you're saying if Denver comes through, then they will go through. I disagree. I think OKC.
No, the thing is, if Denver has beaten San Antonio, then there is no way Denver is going to get beaten by OKC.
Okay,
fair enough. So that means in all likelihood, we both have Warriors, we all three roughly agree, OKC versus Warriors, Western Conference Finals.
Yes.
Warriors or OKC?
I mean, Warriors obviously.
In?
Warriors in five.
Warriors
in six. Warriors in five too. I was going to say that maybe going back to Oklahoma might hurt Durant, but he actually plays really well when he goes back to Oklahoma. Unless there's a thunderstruck situation where there's a little boy who changes powers with Durant. Unless in that very specific
situation.
That's a
shout out to a really shitty movie.
No. I've seen Thunderstruck.
I've seen Thunderstruck. That's why I know.
I'm not proud of it. It was 1 hour 28 minutes wasted of my life.
Waste,
But anyways, unless it's a thunderstruck situation.
I'm going to inflate my cojones to
a keep guardian. A cojones.
I'm going to inflate them to a gigantic size.
Yes, sir.
And say Warriors in seven.
I think
OKC are going to really, really push their buttons. And if we go through what we had said earlier, which is Warriors beating Clippers, they're going to be easy. In case they have Utah coming through, like you said, if there's an upset, OKC is really going to test them. And the thing is, they have a bone to pick with that team. Like, both teams have a bone to pick with each other.
See, but the thing is, OKC is the only team which considers there's a bone to pick. Warriors do not ever think that there's a bone to pick.
Yeah, because they are fully aware of their superiority.
So what I'm saying is, OKC plays with more of its heart than its brain, and Warriors have always played more with, you know, their brain.
I feel, I get your point in the sense, I think Thunder physically matched really well against Warriors' weaknesses.
Right.
But I think if this series had come earlier in the playoffs, yeah, I would give Thunder a bit of an advantage. True. I think by the time we get to the conference finals, the Warriors would be humming
already
at its, they'd be just destroying people.
Yeah, they know this stuff. It'll
take them actually the first two series to like get the reps.
Sure.
And I think, I think by this point, they'll be so prepared for the Thunder. And they'll actually be glad they're not facing the Rockets.
Right.
I think the Rockets, there's a mental block somewhere
right
with the Warriors that, man, these guys will just shoot threes. They do not give two shits. Whereas the Thunder are one of the worst three-point shooting teams in the league, but they take a lot of threes.
Right.
So it's, I think the Warriors, I don't think the Warriors fear them. And you're right, the Thunder are more emotional about it.
Yeah.
The Warriors are just clinical.
Right. My concern, and the reason I gave OKC an extra game there, because ideally you would expect the Warriors to wrap them up in six games.
Mm-hmm.
I think they get an extra game because the Warriors still, which is kind of...
If it goes to a seven game, then I would say Thunder will win. If it goes to a seven, yeah. If it goes
I still think the Warriors win the
game. If it goes to seven games, then either something has happened very weirdly, as in Thunder was up 3-0 and then they lost the next three games. Or
no, my
if they've come back, then in the 7-game series, I would give...
This would either way, I think this would be the most exciting series of the playoffs.
I agree. Just considering
the histories involved.
It better make it to this point.
Like,
I genuinely think that even if it's a 5-game series, even if the Warriors, it's just going to be interesting.
It'll be the most interesting.
I think every game is going to be close.
Yes.
I think the odds of a massive blowout game, and again, see, the thing is also with blowout games is very strange, right? Sometimes the game looks like a blowout, but you realize, okay, that's because it was close till like the middle of the fourth quarter, then they threw in the garbage time, and then the garbage team scored 20 points more. So I think it's going to be a really tight game across quarters, I think it's going to be a really tight series across quarters, not across games. I feel Warriors in 7, and Warriors over Toronto.
Yeah.
And you got Boston.
I mean,
you've got
Warriors,
Boston out of the East.
Yeah, but still Warriors over.
Warriors over Boston's scoreline.
I don't know, 4-2. It's not that difficult for them.
And Warriors over Milwaukee. Warriors over Toronto.
I think this is the Warriors' toughest series. The finals will be their toughest challenge. I think
Warriors
still
versus
win it.
Kawhi. That's what I love.
I think they still win, but it'll probably be a tough 4-2. I think the Raptors will give them, because so far I haven't had them go past 5 in any series.
Right.
And I think this will be the first time they'll be truly tested, because the Raptors are really deep, and I actually feel that any of those four teams in the East will give them a tougher challenge than anyone in the West this year. This is the first time in a long time I actually feel even the year they lost in the finals to the Cavs, to me I think the toughest challenge was the Thunder. You know, but in this case is an exception. I really like all four of these Eastern Conference teams matching up against Golden State. But
I think Warriors in 6 over Toronto. I think if Boston comes through, Warriors in 5. I don't think Boston holds a candle to the Warriors.
Yeah, if Boston has made it to the finals, then obviously they've done something well.
I mean, sure, but just look at the talent, man. Because if the Warriors are making
talent-wise, how are they dissimilar? Like, talent-wise, Boston and Warriors have similar talent.
My dear friend, they have two people who have got an average of 5 years in the league.
Doesn't matter.
Of course it matters.
No, it doesn't matter. I'm talking about talent-wise.
We are talking
purely talent-wise. Like, talent-wise, Jason Tatum is an amazing scorer.
Who needs reps in the playoffs? You're not beating the Warriors in the finals with 1 year under your belt.
I'm talking about talent. I'm not talking about what they've done so far. Because
that's important, right? Because you're talking about winning the series.
No, I'm saying if they get it there, then Boston has a much better chance of beating Warriors than Toronto. Because Boston has the better talent. Because Boston and Warriors, I feel, have similar talent. It's just that Warriors are a powerhouse who've done this 2 times before. Absolutely demolished every single team on the way.
How are you saying similar talent? I mean, Curry and Irving cross each other out, right? Klay Thompson and Tatum, you can pretty much cross each other out, because
like every single person on the Boston Celtics starting five is a proper 3-point shooter. It's not the same case on the Warriors.
Yeah, but the point is, I feel the Warriors are just so much more organized.
That they are a much better matchup than Toronto. That's it. I'm not saying anything else. I feel pretty sure. I mean, even though I predicted it's not like, you know, this is going to happen. I'll be very surprised if Boston make it to the finals. But if Boston make it to the finals and Warriors make it to the finals, that will be very, very close series because they are really close.
I think it's going to be. Warriors will win.
So I think
that's it. Question before we close.
Question for us or for?
Yeah, question for you guys.
Yes, sir.
I'll start with Baba Ashwin.
We
call you Baba Ash now. It sounds a little cooler.
No, please, no.
Yeah, because Babas have a lot of ash around them. Does DeMarcus Cousins play in crunch time for the Warriors?
Definitely. Why not? Why not? I mean, he's a little bitchin' sometimes, but on this team, you know, it he doesn't have to lose his head. He doesn't have to do many things. Like, he's not a great defender. He's not like Draymond Green or anything, but I mean,
The Warriors are down three. They've taken a timeout.
He's a good free throw shooter.
Their Warriors are down three.
Okay.
They have taken a timeout.
Mm-hmm.
They've got the ball in their hands.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry. The Warriors are up two.
Okay.
The opposition has the ball in their hands. They've got the timeout. They've got the ball. The Warriors are on defense now, up two, with one possession left.
Mm.
Is DeMarcus Cousins on the floor?
That's a very weirdly specific question, but I don't see why not.
My only concern with Cousins is the fact that defensively he's going to be a problem in crunch time.
I mean, the Warriors just switch, right? I mean, what is the big deal? Warriors.
He doesn't switch quick, no?
No, he doesn't have, like, so if you're trying to get a three-pointer, that means you don't have to worry about the two-pointer or something, right? I understand what you're saying. Is he a defensive liability at the end of the game? Something
like that. I'm not saying he's I'm saying he is. Do you think he is?
No, man, like, I don't think it'll matter because Warriors, like, they're gonna score. You can't really stop the Warriors. Like, only the Warriors can stop themselves. WI.
Baba K?
I think that's a very good question, sir. Because I've thought about this too. And I think this is a potential inkling of WI happening. Because I don't think Cousins should be on the floor for close fourth quarters. I'm not even saying that last situation you said. I'm just saying they like to go to Cousins early in the game.
Right.
You know, in a lot of the situations, they let him get his points early, so he's satisfied. Or he plays a lot with the bench crew. I've seen a lot in blowouts, he'll stay on the floor.
Right.
You know, like, get his reps with them. Great player, one of my favorites. Great offensive player, love his passion, love when he gets angry at people, it's awesome. But all that said, I actually think that they trust their death lineup a lot.
Right.
The lineup of Steph, Clay, Iggy, KD and Draymond. And I think that's the lineup that's going to close games for them. And it might cause some potential issues with Cousins wanting to play and Kerr keeping him on the bench. And like all of a sudden, they're bringing in Iguodala who's not scoring. But all of a sudden, the plus minus is so much higher without Cousins. And people are pointing it out in the media and stuff. And he starts complaining. Like, there is that inkling of a possibility.
Sure.
But So to make this long-winded thing short, no, I don't think Cousins should be on the floor.
I have two concerns with Cousins. One is that defensively he's not trustworthy in terms of just switching plays.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and I agree with you that if it's a three-pointer, you don't really need to worry. You need to cover the perimeter. And I agree with you. But the problem is a team like the Rockets will put five shooters on the floor.
Yeah.
And suddenly then Cousins becomes a liability there. You have no clue.
If there are five shooters, then obviously you don't put...
But you don't know who's coming out of the timeout, right? Unless you like wait and you see, okay, these people have put these people. Okay, let's... That's a little shady way of
kind of... I think
they
go and talk to the scorers, right?
No, you can't. Like, ideally you
can't. We see this happening a lot in the playoffs when, like, very often the biggest guy becomes obsolete in many series.
Right.
Like, it becomes unplayable. No matter how talented he is, if he's too slow. And this is why I think the Warriors are so special. Like, we had a long argument about this, like the Steph Curry question, you know. But the fact that Draymond can be a 4 or a 5 and defend both positions so well, even a weak shooting Draymond, I think that's why he's turned them. Now every team plays small ball. Now every team can put out a 6'7" center. LeBron has played center in like major stretches, which was unbelievable. But Draymond is the one that made it all possible. Like, his ability to be the five for long stretches, and I think they are so used to those reps that they will just trust him. And I think
Warriors even got Andrew Bogut back. mean,
they got him back, but again, I'll be shocked if Bogut's for
locker room presence.
Yeah. And either that or like basically like elbowing Gobert in his face, like, you know, the fouls.
Maybe,
he might play 10 minutes in the whole playoffs, I think.
Right.
And I think it's a locker room presence. That guy brings a grit. Like, you don't want to meet Andrew Bogut in a dark alley because he's going to beat the shit out of you.
Yeah,
guys.
My
final point is my other concern with DeMarcus Cousins. He's not been in a serious playoff situation.
He's not been in any playoff situation.
Yeah, right.
I mean, his first playoff game.
Yeah. Sure, yeah. But my point is that...
But why are we talking about Draymond? Like, DeMarcus Cousins. DeMarcus Cousins on that team is like, I don't know what, he's like an extra ball of gulab jamun.
Because of the potential.
My point is...
He has a big ego.
He is a good problem to have, but he is a problem that the Warriors have to figure out. I'm not saying that... To be very clear, I'm not saying that DeMarcus Cousins is a bad...
DeMarcus Cousins is not going to determine what happens in this
playoff. I think it's going to be an X factor.
No, I don't think he even came with that thing. I mean, I think because of Achilles, he just...
Sure, showed up if that's the case, then yeah, but the first time he's going to be in a playoff situation, so we have no clue how he's going to behave. That's my concern.
I think the very first game against the Clippers, he's going to go ballistic. They're going to just feed him the ball every chance they get. He might end up with like 13, 15. In three quarters, something like that,
and that's the way to go ahead with DeMarcus Cousins. Yeah. Get him, like you said, get him those reps early.
DeMarcus Cousins
happy.
Is a beast.
And yeah, that's it. We disagreed on a bunch of things.
Yes.
We agreed on a few things. You decided that you would resurrect some dead players. And
nobody is dead, yeah.
No, I didn't mean to say dead players in the sense like physically dead, but like, you know, 2009 Dwight Howard, like God knows.
He got back Bill Walton.
Bill Walton and, you know, surprisingly didn't get Malone and Stockton for the Utah Jazz series. Boston is going to make it to the finals. I don't know what's wrong with you. but anyways, what's great is that we all agree that the Warriors are going to be the NBA champions in 2019.
Yes.
After that, you know, the New York Knicks are taking KD and Irving.
He doesn't want Irving.
Yeah, I don't want Irving.
You don't want Irving? Okay, just take KD.
Then they'll definitely take Irving.
Okay, then. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys. Baba K, Baba Ashwin, see our Twitter handles at the bottom. That's the director's job. He's going to do that. Come at us, troll us, tell us what we're doing wrong. But come at us with some valuable suggestions, some valuable points. Make sense. Don't say shitheads and then just wrap it up. thanks anyways for watching. Hit subscribe once again and we will see you after 4 weeks.
We'll see you soon.
Thanks.